So guys, the first thing we will do is take out this petrol pipe that is fitted inside the bike, and we will take this out of the machine now and throw it away. And guys, the fuel inside our bike right now, we are going to drain it out. You can see that the petrol that is there inside the bike is now draining out. And now what we'll do is we will simply allow this petrol to drain completely. Now let's open the petrol tank in this manner. And we have with us over here a lot of water, close to 20 liters. Let us now put it inside this petrol tank on this bike. Something like this. You can clearly see that this is water and it is plenty of water, guys. So we had put up a video earlier in which we had run the vehicle on alcohol. So a lot of people commented that if you have the guts, then try and run the vehicle on water. So you can see that we are filling up the bike petrol tank with water, because in today's video we are going to run this bike not on petrol but on water. So now let's start. We already have titanium in our blood. You please don't try to attempt any of this at home. Alright guys, so you can see that we have filled this tank completely with water. This is right now completely filled with water. But guys, running the bike on water in this manner is impossible. So we'll have to think a little more scientifically for this. So what we'll need for this is a pressure cooker and some calcium carbide. This in my hand, guys, is calcium carbide. And the amazing thing about this is that if we put it in water, then a really wonderful and flammable gas, acetylene, is generated. And we are going to use that to run the bike. Because guys, normally running a bike on water is something that you already know is an impossible task. So in this manner, we can run the bike on water. You can see over here, I've simply taken a piece of calcium carbide. I put it inside this. Along with that, we will also need a narrow pipe like this. You can easily find this pipe at any medical or pharmacy store. And we are simply going to connect this in this manner. And right at the end of this, you can see that we have attached a normal injection. And now what we'll do is we simply put some water in it. Now you can see the manner in which gas is getting generated from this reaction. Now what we'll do, we will simply close the lid of this pressure cooker. And now the gas that gets generated will come out from here. And this over here is very simple mechanism through which we can control the flow on this. We can control the amount of gas that is coming out of this. And guys, if we open this nozzle and try to light it up, then you can see the amazing gas that comes shooting out of there. Look. This is so hot that we can also do welding with the help of this. Look. Now what we'll do, we'll simply take it here. You can see that over here is the bike's air intake, the air intake pipe. So what we'll do, we will simply take this injection, we will straighten away, insert it inside this pipe in this sort of manner. Something like this. Because of the cold, this pipe has become a little rigid. We have to take care of not breaking or not bending this needle and carefully insert it straight into this like this. And now what we'll do is, we have this controller over here. We will now turn it on. Alright guys, now this entire setup is complete and ready. So now let us start the bike and see whether the bike starts or not. You can see that this petrol tank here is completely filled up with the water. So come on, let's now try and start the bike and see if the bike is really able to run like this or not. Let us now close this. Guys, this has no purpose. We have just done this so that you believe us that we don't make any fake. I mean, we don't make any fake videos. Many people can claim that there was a petrol in the tank. So come on now, let's start the bike and see. Alright guys, so bike has managed to start. The bike is now starting. It has started! But it is not starting in the same way that it starts with petrol. Let's try to open the nozzle a little more. Now let's start. It's really not so easy to run a bike on water. Shake. What's the problem, man? Is the needle bent or something?
No, it's perfect.
The needle is okay. It did start once, right?
Yes, it
this
had started.
This has exhausted me, man. Shake it, shake it. Slowly,
keep it
slowly.
Moving, keep it moving.
It shouldn't overflow. Let's do one thing. According to me, we had put in a small piece of carbide. Let's put a slightly bigger piece inside this. And then let's try to start the bike. Bring a bigger piece quickly. So this time, let's put both these bigger pieces inside. Then let us try to start the bike. Gas is still there, but it is less. Bring the bottle of water. Bring it quick, man. It is getting dark. We are shooting a video. First, let's put some water inside this. This time, let's put two big pieces inside this. Now let's try to start the bike. The nozzle is open and the needle is also inserted. It's happening. Hey! Alright guys, the bike has started. Hey, pick up the cooker and sit. Come. Come and sit. Keep that a little away. Alright guys, so come on, let's try to ride the bike a little bit. There is a strange sound coming out of the engine. So come on, let's ride the bike and see that with this amount of calcium carbide, how far this bike can run. Let's go. Shake it, shake the cooker.
Yeah, I like it. It's running.
Woo-hoo! It has stopped. Oh, it has stopped now. Take it back. Hey, shut off the nozzle, otherwise it will overflow. The pressure cooker, it must be pretty hot now.
Oh, yes.
Take it back.
I think I should sit now.
Sit. Okay, sit.
Come on, let's go.
Hang on, let me shut off the nozzle.
Should I shake it again?
Hey, shake it slowly or it will get explode.
You will hurt your head. Keep it away from your head.
Please start. It started.
Let's go.
Going. Alright guys, so now this has completely stopped. Just check how much pressure is left in the cooker.
It is very hot.
It's getting hot, right?
Yes.
It's getting hot, right?
Yes.
Alright guys, so finally we managed to start our bike. Hey, remove this from here now. Take it away. Take it far away. But guys, we just made this video to show you that the bike engine can be run on anything that is flammable. For example, alcohol, petrol, diesel, many gases like LPG or acetylene gas. But the problem with that is that if the engine is built for the petrol, then it should be run on petrol alone. Otherwise, the life of the engine gets shortened. The engine gets severely damaged by these kind of experiments. And you guys, please don't try to attempt any of this anywhere at all, because the pressure that gets generated on creation of acetylene gas is very high. Our pressure cooker could have easily exploded if we had put more than the required amount of calcium carbide. So that's it for today. You can see that just by applying our brains a little, we can run a bike on water as well. So that's it for today. We'll meet again in the next video. Until then, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.